of this kind of abuse say it is the worst kind. People of faith preying on people who pray. The group Silent Lambs was in Nashville today showing their support for people who say they've been abused by Jehovah's Witnesses and others. Recently, lawsuits were settled in some cases, but not to the satisfaction of Silent Lambs. Channel 4's Cynthia Williams is live now at Kingdom Hall in West Nashville with the story. Cynthia?
Well, there are about six Kingdom Halls in the Nashville area, including the one here in West Nashville that's over my shoulder. And today, Silent Lambs attached this bulletin to the door of each one. At least, that attempt was made.
So, recently 16 lawsuits were settled.
Who called you?
Silent Lambs met with vocal resistance today at a Kingdom Hall in Woodbine.
You haven't been invited on the property.
For 6 years now, the Kentucky-based organization has offered support for people alleging abuse within the Jehovah's Witnesses faith. In March, settlements were reached in more than a dozen molestation cases, agreements that came with gag orders attached.
We find this bittersweet. On one hand, we're glad a few victims were finally getting some financial help, but on the other hand, we're sad and worried because they've been forced to give up their right.
Bill Bowen is a former Jehovah's Witness and founder of Silent Lambs. He was surrounded by abuse victims today from various faiths.
When I was around 8 years old, I was molested by a teenager who was a member of my church, Christian Gospel Temple.
There are thousands of us out there and thousands of children that need our help right now.
My parents nor anyone else ever knew that I was abused by an elder.
According to Silent Lambs, the Jehovah's Witnesses policies encourage abuse by not reporting allegations to police, choosing instead to handle individual cases internally. Today, a stuffed lamb was placed on the doors of area Kingdom Halls, telling victims they need be silent no more. And victims groups say that they are critical of these gag orders because they tend to keep the identity of the predator secret while re-victimizing the victim. Live in West Nashville, I'm Cynthia Williams, Channel 4 News.
The Jehovah's Witnesses headquarters in Brooklyn was supposed to send a faxed response today, but as of news time, we have not received it.